Welcome to my channel. I am Chris Menard. Let's take a look at printing in Microsoft Excel. Let's dive in right now. We have this Excel file running. It is human resource data. I've got a list of employees, their hire date, social, payroll information, and department and family type. I want to go to File, Print. You can also do Control, and the letter P is the keyboard shortcut for File, Print. Print Preview opens. On page one at the top, in the very top, is the header row that I had running. You can scroll down with either your mouse using the scroll wheel. And if you notice, I've got a total of 12 pages at the very bottom. The issue is when I get to page seven, I had columns over to the far right in my data that are now taking up pages 7 through 12. And again, the header row repeated at the top of page 7, but not on the other pages. I could change the orientation from portrait to landscape, but I want to keep this portrait and I want to add a few other items. Let's go back and see if we can fix this. One easy fix, and I use this quite a bit, is there's frequently data that no one else really needs to see, or even if they need to see it, it doesn't help when we print this report. In my example, we don't need to be showing hire date all the way over to household type. I'm going to select column G, all the way over to column K. I'm going to right-click and hide. I can immediately tell now we don't have the extra pages over to the right from this line. Also want this header row to repeat on every page. So that's employee ID over to department. I'm going to go to the page layout tab at the top. We have the page setup group. This is print titles. If you're saying, Chris, go down to rows to repeat at top and type in the number one, that won't work. I put in a one. I go to print preview. And it says the reference isn't valid. What you have to do is in the background, click on row one. Now we can go to print preview from here. Back in print preview, look at the bottom. I've got six pages. The header row is on page one. Scroll down, two, three. You can use the arrows also down here to move over. And you can even use the scroll bar to quickly scroll through here. So that took care of that. Other items I want to do. So I like the way this report looks. I've got a total number of pages, but I want to reference the day it was printed, the name of the file, and the total number of pages also in here. A couple different places you can do this. I'm going to get out of print preview. I could do this from print titles, just so you know that. But in the bottom right corner, we have three different views in Excel. Normal view is where we are usually working at. That is the first icon here. Move over to the right and we have page layout view. And the final view is page break preview. I'm going to use page layout to do my headers and footers. I'm in page layout view. Here's the very first page. If you've worked in Microsoft Word with headers and footers, this is very similar. I'm going to click in Add Header. I want the name of the file here. In case I ever need to print this again, it's easy to find the name of the file. Over on the left-hand side, I would like to know what day it was printed. I'm going to type in date printed, colon, space bar, and then put in the current date. I could even do the current time if I wanted to. Over on the right-hand side, I want people to know that I prepared it, so I'm going to put in my name. So that includes the header. In the footer of the document, I'd like the current page number and the total number of pages, so I'm just going to scroll down there. You can also actually just click on Go to Footer. It'll jump you down to the bottom, or you can scroll down here. Where do you want the page numbers? It's totally up to you. I'm going to put them right here in the middle. I'm going to put page, space bar, page number. So if I'm on page one, that'll be page one. If I'm on page two, it'll be page two. Space bar of, and now I want the total number of pages. Page one of In my example, it was 6 pages total. So this will say page 1 is 6, page 2 is 6. To get out of here, you can pop back into normal view. Just click out of here first, click back in your data, and then there is normal view. Let's go see if that worked. Control P or file print, top left corner, date printed. Name of the file is sitting here. My name is on the right and down at the bottom, page 1 of 6. Just scroll down and page 2 of 6. It is working. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Any comments, put them down below. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.